We are now less than 24 hours away from the start of the Iowa caucuses. Good evening, I'm Jennifer Lenzini. An attorney for the Army Corps of Engineers is asking a judge to sign off on the Corps' conclusion that the Dakota Access Oil Pipeline doesn't harm American Indian tribe. Still, the final results here at Precinct 10 are in. Now, there were a total of 186 participants. In order for a candidate to be viable, they had to have had at least 28 votes. I briefly spoke with someone from the Woodbury County Sheriff's Department, and he said that there were no injuries. The water behind me is fast flowing, and you can see the road to my left is not passable either via vehicle or on foot. Now look how easy this is to hide. This right here is a typical flash drive, while this is an e-cigarette known as a Juul. They look virtually the same. We begin with breaking news out of Plymouth County. One man was sent to the hospital after an accident just south of Lamar's. Volunteers say that they've been here since 6 a.m. and there have been a steady flow of voters ever since they opened. Now, right before the 5 o'clock hour, just in Precinct 1, there was over 830 voters that had already voted. Over 25,000. That's the number of people that are food insecure here in Siouxland, 11,000 of which our children. Now, nearly 2 years later, Chad Plant and his wife, Roseanne, continue to deal with repercussions from the accident. Chad Plant suffered a traumatic brain injury and two broken legs. And state football action from across Nebraska. Join us tonight on News 4 at 10. Yeah, Matt and Stella, Chief Rex Mueller's wife, Sandra, has been diagnosed with breast cancer. But this isn't her first cancer battle. She was diagnosed once before and beat it. Now, the cancer has come back.
My nickname for her is Angel. It always has been. That's just what I call her.
Sioux City Police Chief Rex Mueller has been with the department since 1996. He has faced many challenges while on the job, but none like the one he is facing at home.
My wife is a survivor of 12 years and was re-diagnosed recently. And after 12 years, you feel like you're kind of in the clear. And she received her diagnosis and then has since been going through treatment and chemotherapy.
Treatment that includes various side effects. Many can be grueling. Chief Mueller says he admires the way his wife has handled those difficulties.
Would I have rather gone through it myself than watch my wife go through it? Yeah, I'd take her place in a second.
Making the man who many look up to his best friend.
My wife has kind of become my hero in the way that she responds to this and has taken this on, and she doesn't let it get in the way of her desire to be, you know, a part of the community and to be a mother and to be a wife.
Chief Mueller lost his father to cancer last year, giving him more reason behind his passion for the Pink Patch Project.
A side effect for anybody going through this is to kind of treasure every day, is to know that, you know, life is precious and that you got to go one moment at a time, and that when you're confronted with things like that, it only reminds you how temporary things can be and to make the best of every moment.
So it'll be exactly like nothing else in the United States.
Amra and Amy Gill are two of the developers for the Warrior Hotel. Their hope is to bring back life to one of Sioux City's most historic buildings. Now, this building has not been touched in nearly 37 years. But by next summer, that won't be the story. Project officials hope to include luxury hotels, apartments, restaurants, and even a bowling alley.
There'll be a spa, there'll be an indoor pool, there'll be sauna, fitness.
A bowling alley, all kinds of wonderful restaurants. So the food scene will change in downtown Sioux City with this project.
And the nearly century-old building looks to be sturdy enough to accommodate all of the Gill's expectations.
This building is in great shape. All the numbers we've shot so far, it's really held its line for a 100-year-old building.
And the Gills don't want to shy away from the rich history of the building.
We want to instill this community and this project in this community.
And fill it with local businesses.
The money stays in the local economy.
The goal? That all of the community will be able to take advantage and enjoy the experiences of the project.
Luxury hotels, the experience of staying at an autograph collection is for all ages. It's not just for one particular set.
Morning, Iowa residents are allowed back into homes today, but only for a few hours. Good evening and thanks for joining us. I'm Jennifer Lenzini. At 2 p.m. today, residents and property owners were allowed back into the town. But Woodbury County Emergency Management are advising everyone entering to be out of the town by 8 p.m. tonight. Again, that's 8 p.m. tonight for residents that return to Hornick. Due to the sewer system not functioning, those returning will not be allowed to run any water to their houses. Hornick Mayor Scott Mitchell asked residents to not pump any water out of your basements and avoid flooded areas. Power remains shut off in the community and will not be restored today. Earlier today, Governor Kim Reynolds was in Hornick, Iowa, surveying the area. The governor went to homes and rode around the area to see the damage done by heavy flooding. By 4 p.m., the governor was at the Sioux Gateway Airport. KTIV's Ashley Richardson was at today's news conference with Governor Reynolds and brings us the latest. Now, Ashley, what did the governor have to say earlier? Releases from Gavin's Point Dam were reduced again Sunday morning. The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers says they reduced them to 53,000 cubic feet per second this morning. And they will be further reducing it to 43,000 CFS this evening. The Des Moines River has overflowed its banks due to, in part, to ice jams clogging up the river. And the town of Lehigh, Iowa, is paying the price. Siouxland has been hit with a lot of rain and flooding this last week, but the weather is predicted to get drier in the coming days. For the full story, we're joined by meteorologist Leslie London to see if things are going to be a bit calmer this coming week. We hope so, right, Leslie?
I'll have more on all of that coming up in my full forecast.
All right, we look forward to it. Thank you, Leslie. A portion of Interstate 29 in Sioux City remains closed due to ponding water. The city announced Saturday afternoon that I-29 underpass is closed. However, the north and southbound ramps to I-29 remain open. The Iowa Department of Transportation will be posting a detour for the impacted parts of I-29. The Dakota Dunes is not out of the woods yet, per se, but water is beginning to recede. That's where we find KTIV's Danielle Seda. Now, Danielle, tell us about how this flooding has affected locals in the Rushmore State. Governor Ricketts adds that there are ways that Nebraskans can help fellow Nebraskans. He says you can contact the Nebraska and Iowa Red Cross to donate time, money, or blood. And you can also contact your emergency manager to help support their efforts. A mandatory curfew has been put in place for the city of Pierce, Nebraska. There will be a mandatory curfew from Wood Street east to the flood control dike beginning at 8 p.m. this evening. This curfew will be in effect until 8 a.m. Monday morning. City officials ask that all residents in that area to check in at the fire station to obtain an ID badge. Persons without ID badges will not be allowed to enter the area during that curfew.